Hi, this is your epilepsy neurologist, Dr. Omar Danoun, and today I will talk about the month of Ramadan fasting and its effect on epilepsy, and I will give you 5 tips for the best treatment and management of epilepsy during the month of Ramadan. There are 2 billion Muslims around the world observe the month of Ramadan by fasting, and the fasting usually happens between the dawn, which is about 1 hour before sunrise, and the sunset. And there are 2 main meals. One at dawn is called sahur, and one at breakfast, which is called iftar. So tip number one is fasting. Ramadan depends on the type of seizure control that the patient has and the type of epilepsy. For seizures and epilepsy that is very well controlled, with no seizures for months or years, and the patient is taking only one medication or maximum of 2 medication, but other very stable regimen for years, then at that time the patient can possibly fast and the medication can be changed to the iftar and suhoor times. However, this should be prepared very well in advance with the treating neurologist, and the timing of the medications can be pushed to the sides of the day slowly until it reaches to that time. And if medications were given once a day, they can be given at the end of the day with the iftar meal. However, if the medications are given 3 times a day, there is no way that we can make a reliable regimen for that was given twice a day. And there are stretches of time during the day that the patient is not covered, and that creates a high risk for seizure recurrence. So it is advised that the patient is taking 3 times a day medication, not to fast, or you can ask your doctor to switch you to a different medication, but that should be planned ahead of time. And the patients should always ask their treating neurologist for the best advice for themselves. So tip number 2, in patients who have uncontrolled seizures or refractory epilepsy, which usually is about 30% of the patients, and they are still having frequent seizures despite being on 2 or more medications, and in those patients, fasting or changing in the timing of medications can exacerbate their seizures and make them worse, or sometimes can cause a life-threatening condition called status epilepticus when seizures happen and they do not stop, and sometimes they need hospitalization. So in those patients, fasting is not advised because it can worsen their epilepsy. And tip number 3, we can consider preparing before Ramadan by changing the medication formulation into an extended-release formulation. So extended-release formulation is a medication design that releases the medication slowly into the blood throughout the day, and that can prevent fluctuations or dips in the levels when the medication are given far apart. And sometimes what we do is to increase the medication levels to prevent lower levels of medications throughout the day. And sometimes we can increase the dose of the medication so that the patient will be better covered and seizures won't happen if the medication levels get lower throughout the day, especially in areas of the world when the fasting hours are very long. Tip number 4, for patients who have newly diagnosed epilepsy and seizures, it is better to consider not fasting because they are sensitive to changes in medication levels early on, and if seizures happen in this critical time of their epilepsy, it can worsen their epilepsy and make it more difficult to control. So it is better not to make changes in the timing of medications early on in the first year of epilepsy. And tip number 5, the most important one, is to control the patient's lifestyle. So we know that sleep deprivation is a major trigger for seizures, and patients are advised to get enough sleep throughout the day and night and avoid staying up late in the night, and they should sleep early in the night, and when they wake up in the morning for their sahur and breakfast time, they should consider going back to sleep and wake up for their work afterwards. And also, to avoid hunger, patients are advised to eat enough and diverse amount of food, and they can concentrate, especially in the sahur, which is the breakfast meal, on complex carbohydrate and high protein food, and those type of nutrients, they can secure a constant supply of glucose throughout the day, which prevents hunger, which can be a major trigger for seizures in some patients. And patients also should be very well hydrated and avoid excessive sunlight exposure and heavy exercise, because they also can trigger seizures in some patients. And very important, if the patient misses their dose in the morning, early morning at the sahur meal, and wake up without taking the morning dose, I think they should break their fast that day and take their medication, because if they waited for another 12 or 16 hours, that can be a long time without medications, and seizures can happen during that time. Thank you so much for watching, and Ramadan Mubarak.